Hey, Harvest. You know, there are just so many amazing illustrations that are coming around out of this whole pandemic with the coronavirus, including, you know, this week, you know, a lot of the high-up leadership within the federal government was talking about this week being one of the most difficult weeks to expect in this whole global pandemic. And what an amazing thing that it coincides with Holy Week. You know, the week that Christians traditionally celebrate the lead up to the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ this weekend. You know, the lead up to that is all of the old world and all of the old self and the darkness and the slavery. And then through the resurrection of Jesus on Sunday, the hope and the life and everything that we have to look forward to. And I think just such a great reminder of that is in 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 3. Look at how critical the resurrection of Jesus Christ is to our hope. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. According to His great mercy, He has caused us to be born again to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. That hope, that living hope, is based on the resurrection of Jesus Christ. You know, I think one of the big challenges that we have as Christians is to live in this life while also looking forward to the next life. And in a sense, there's an overlapping of two worlds. Remember last week, you know, when Jesus in Matthew 6 was talking about, as we studied that passage, He said to seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness. That's what we should be doing instead of focusing on what we're to be worried about, you know, and the anxieties of this world. Let me just use my board here to show you what I mean by two worlds overlapping. You know, your life starts and it goes along into eternity, and at some point in your life, Christian, you come to know Jesus. You meet Him and you understand your need for a Savior, and you put your faith in Him as the covering and the sacrifice for your sins. And then you continue on in life until at some point your physical body dies and you experience the resurrection that we look forward to in the future for us. And when Jesus talks about the kingdom of God, it's this world that we're now living in, but we're also living in this old self, right? So there's the old, and remember in Colossians we talked about putting off the old self and putting on the new, and that would be that kingdom, the kingdom of God. And but we're living right here. That's where we're living. We're living in this difficult place. Now what He wants us to do is turn from being anxious and worry, instead to have a living hope. I hope you can see that, speaking of hope. But we're living right here, where we've got, in one sense, one foot in the old and one foot in the new. Rather than focusing on anxious and worry, we look forward to the new kingdom. We seek that. And that living hope is based, what? On Jesus' resurrection from the dead. And then look down to verse 6. He says, in this you rejoice, though now for a little while, if necessary, you have been grieved by various trials. So I'm going to put trials right here, because that's the world we're in right now, trials. Verse 7, so that the tested genuineness of your faith, more precious than gold that perishes, though it is tested by fire, may be found to result in praise and glory and honor at the resurrection of Jesus Christ. So I want to do a short video each day as we lead up to this week, but I first want you to realize that we are called to live in a living hope because of the resurrection of Jesus Christ, not in the old world with anxiety and worry about what's going on, but also realize that these various trials that we face in this life, they tempt us either to go back to the old, to be anxious and worry, or it says in verse 7 that God uses them to refine our faith, to refine our faith. So just one thing I want to ask you in closing here. How is God using the various trials that he has you in right now to refine your faith? What is he carving off? What is he buffing and smoothing out in your heart that needs to be changed, right? So maybe it's an aspect of your life that just needs to end, that the new person needs to come, the old needs to go away, and I need to lean to that. So trials, various trials are pointing us towards being anxious and worrying about the old, or to seek the kingdom and to live in a new and living hope. Harvest, you are loved.